Well, welcome back to Springhills Farm 2015 edition. So I've made a decision. First, we are going to get rid of this, because I don't like it. And we're going to buy another tractor with a front loader on it. Second, I'll be back in a moment. That's better, not so loud. A lot of people like this weedy man, and I can't claim that I do. I have never used one. I love it's a more traditional front loader at home. This has got a telescopic arm on it, and it's a pretty good piece of kit. No doubt about it, it might, but it's not going to be on Springhill Farm in my case. No siree, Bob. It is, it's going to be sold. So heading down into the village for the first time. That's the brewery there that I'm looking at off to the left. And the village shops and so on and so forth, post office and stuff there. There's a red British box, telephone box in there as well. And there's a bio plant up here on the right, just opposite the gate we're going to use on the left here. So the bio is there behind the railing on the right, and we're going in here to the left to sell this front loader and buy ourselves a Ford. Okay, so how'd we get? Now, just for the record, if we go to owned, there's the weedy man at 26, and I can sell remotely for 13. But if I go up here and get to ore, I can sell it for 15,600, so that's 2,600 more, and I'll take that. And by the power of Farming Simulator, it's done. Now it says it wanted used factories and machineries, call for a free quote. We're not a scrapyard. John Deere owners, take note. So I don't know if that's a private joke or something. What's it say down here? We offer three kinds of service: good, cheap, and fast. You can pick up any two. Good service, cheap, won't be fast. Good service, fast, won't be cheap. And fast serviced, cheap, won't be good. I like that. That's kind of cool. I hadn't seen that before either. Oh, look, there's a shed. I hadn't seen that before either. Okay. Now I do want to go and see what tractors we got, so we gotta look at tractors. Now, there's the tractor mod, and what I'm thinking of picking up was this Ford front loader. She's a 6640 model, and she's coming in at a whoop-a-doodle $17,000. Now there is a front loader here for 21.5. It's a Ford 5000. It's an attractive old nostalgic piece of machinery, but I'm going to go with the new and the good, and she's 17 grand, which is going to set me back a few B.O.B. So here's a new tractor. She's a nice, tidy 1997 job. There's a Sigma loader on there. Thought it might be a quickie. The old Tanko was on the older models. We had a quickie at home as well. Got the PTO, and she's got the top end. We got a high and low linkage on her. 3-point bar. Nice, and we get lights, camera, action. Yeah, she's fairly nice and sweet inside, actually. She's She's done well. Now, I'm down to 4 grand, which is not far off of where I started, but I've traded in a machine for 15,600 and put another 1,400 with it to buy this job. So that's handy. I do need to buy a baler as well, but I've got to go and get rid of the other tractor. That was a mistake, actually. Yeah, that was a bit stupid. I haven't really thought this out, have I? Let's go back. I shall use the power of the game to jump from one tractor to the next. And we can maybe go and sell a few yokes. And then bring them back to this tractor. Yeah. I had to drive down here with the front loader anyway, because I couldn't bring very much with that. But now that I have the front loader down here, sold, and I've got the 6640 in the job, I'll just bring this one over here for now and leave it like that. And we'll jump this fella here. Now that's a weight that I think I'll keep. Else here. This is a nice old tractor though, in all fairness, but she's got a tidy price on her, and she's ideal for the small farm setup, you know? I'm going to go down and get this plow, because this plow is worth a few bob, and I don't need it anytime soon. Fly around here mad. I thought they cut across this field, dead hunt, so that's what's going around. Yes, I've been around here before. Now where is she? She's not here. Thick. Down here. Where's the plow? Oh, it's down in the chicken farm. Right. Not here at all. Okay, so I have been here before, but I can't remember what's where. This could be stupid, but we wasn't crying. Not a problem. Look at that. She's well able to handle a bit of water, this tractor. Well, fuel in there is not really worth all that much, actually. I keep that sewing machine. This trailer is I think I'll keep it for now. I need a trailer immediately. I need a baler. But I need a bigger trailer as well. And I also need a corn harvester. I was going to look for some mods at the time, and I didn't really do enough of that, so... We might be chopping and changing this video as we go along. Because we want to get that into the side, which is over here. But we'll have a look around and see what's down here in the in this farm down here now. There's general foghorn, leghorn, but there's the plow. We can definitely pick that up on the way back. Just want to run up here and show you the way around. So that's that maze in there that we're chaffing and putting into this silage pit up here. Fairly sizable silage pit there, which is not too bad. And then there's an overhang on the shed here for feeding sheeps, which is the blue of the sheep. And there's a bit of storage space here for a few yolks. I shed on the other side today, a bit of stuff now. A bit of straw in there as well, and I suppose we can put in a little bit of straw for additional bedding just to make sure they're happy. But these fellas seem to be happy to eat away on silage. They don't just need fresh grass. And my intention is to use silage because it's handier, it's manageabler. Off that weight now, which was really a bad call, but yeah, you're alright. She's not there. Right. Off to sell this, if I can make it around. So we'll sell this and we'll make a bit of a decision on what we're doing with a trailer. I'm fairly sure that I'm going to buy that Donnelly trailer. It's 14 ton trailer and you can do a bit with it. It'll come in pretty handy when I'm going to be selling out the harvests that I have in the silo. Learn a few bob from that and turn that into a few other pieces of machinery that I need, namely a baler. Maybe a front fork for the Ford as well, actually. That won't be that expensive. And yeah, we'll see how we're getting on from there. That's the creamery there. She's not handling very well. I'm driving too fast, but yeah, the can I see where I am? I think the weight's fairly significant on that. I'm losing front end. I'm wearing front tires here. I won't be wearing front end tomorrow though. I think I might be hitting the wall, am I? I'm not, no. She's just got awful heavy all of a sudden. This is fine. Things first is to hop out and see what the story is with this plow. So, popping back to owned, we can look and see that the plow is 20, and we'll earn 10.47. Excuse me, 4.750. So. If we're here, we'll sell for 12,570, so we'll get an extra $2,000, which is good. That's 16 grand now. And 16 grand should do a good bit on a trailer. A tipper here. That's the Donnelly 16x8, which is a fine trailer at 12. It leaves me with 4, so that plow would pay for that trailer, so that's a fairly decent idea. Now that this Donnelly here is a 14 ton. And she's good for everything. There's a Johnson down here that's only an 11 ton. And it's 2,500 cheaper though. For 11 tons. 11-ton trailer wouldn't be too bad on the farm here. I have the machinery to pull 14 tons though. And I think 14 will be what I'll buy too, because it'll be that little extra with the trip. It'll just cover me when I'm running, yeah. So we'll buy her. And now, do I sell this trailer or do I not, is the next question. This tractor. I'll earn 47, I'll get 50 odd out of it. Which is, yeah. I will sell her because I can buy a tractor for 17 that matches her. And she's in good nick now, so 47, I get 56, that's a decent deal. Look at me, that puts me 60 grand now. 60 grand will buy a baler. I still just have the one tractor, but I'll be able to do an awful lot with one tractor here. No hours on her, so she's new. I don't know why they're setting off the alarm over there. I don't know if you can hear that, but there's a siren going off. Right, so that'll the conclusion for this video for now. I'll pick you up here a little bit later, but I need to go and look at a few items on the corn harvesting side and make some decisions. So catch you later.